What is going on, everyone, and welcome back to the Stock Trends channel. So in today's video, we are going over ticker symbol SNDL, Sundial Growers. Yet again, we have some fresh news here in the after hours to talk about what this may mean, why it may be a bit more confusing than some may think, and how to actually potentially trade off of this support resistance what we see going on here today. So right now, today, down a little bit. Now, we had the shelf offering S3 or F3, because they're not a U.S. company, on file last week. We anticipated the stock to kind of pull back here into this week, but we have some brand new news. So we dropped today. Makes sense. We kind of saw that coming, but we have some brand new news about what's going on here in the after hours and why we're actually up just under 4%. So here we go, right at the beginning of the after hour session, which we can see by this shading here on Webull, and you can also still get 4 free stocks with Webull, link in the pinned comment description box. You have to make sure you create your account, sign up for your brokerage account. You don't just get those by just like putting your name and email. You actually have an account to actually claim the stocks. So it hit up to 75 cents or just above 75 cents really quickly, and then just sold off. And now we're kind of just sitting and calming down here in the low 70s here in after hours. So we'll see what happens into tomorrow. Well, a bunch of other cannabis related stocks were perking up. Take a peek at CGC here. CGC, just a kind of a slow grinder after the morning dip into the end of the day. So these stocks did look pretty strong, and we'll see what happens with the inauguration tomorrow, obviously. But what was this news, and why, you know, people freaking out about what's going on here? If there's, you know, some questions, concerns. Well, what I want to dive back into is you want to look at some of the SEC filings. So we're using BAMSEC.com right here. We type in ticker symbol SNDL, and what do we see? Well, we have the shelf registration from the 15th, from last week, right? Then we got a RW. We have a registration withdrawal request. So here it is. So this is actually pretty interesting. So it's a short little paragraph that we have right here. And so they're saying that they request the immediate withdrawal of the company's registration statement form F3, which was filed on the 15th, blah, blah, blah. Okay. The registration statement has not yet been declared effective by the commission, and no securities have been issued or sold under this statement. So they didn't actually do an offering yet. So when you have a shelf offering on file, right, they had a $400 million shelf offering. That was what we had on the 15th, right? That's essentially what you have in your back pocket that you can pull from and do offerings. So many times you'll see companies doing like a $25 million offering or like a $10 million direct or maybe like a 300, like I think NNDM just did like a 300 something million dollar offering. So that's where you kind of get that. But you have a shelf of 400. So you can actually pull out of that $400 million offering. And these book runners, they get commissions, and there's other things that go on behind the scenes, which is a whole other story in and of itself. Why, you know, profit targets or why price target upgrades. And sometimes, you know, a lot of these book runners, you know, they also have, you know, like for example, H.C. Wainwright, many times they'll increase their price target, share prices push up, they come as an offering and they get a commission on that. So it's just kind of like a funny little thing that happens in the background as well. But this last line, I think people are not looking at, because what you're going to see is a lot of people are getting the little thing, they're seeing that their withdrawal, blah, blah, blah. What's this last line say? The company decided to withdraw its registration statement and file a new registration statement on form F3 ASR. So while the news and the headline of this actual thing reads pretty good, this is a little bit, you know, somewhat concerning on the back end. Just understand that that is still there. So does this is kind of them playing some games here, in my opinion. We'll look at the chart. What does the chart say? We still have to worry about potentially what they have going on behind the scenes here. I'm still waiting to see some more clarification from the company on this. We'll see if they issued a press release or if they talk about their current cash standing. I believe they're debt-free. That's what they recently talked about. But what we saw from ZOM, from ZOM today, they came out with a shareholder letter. So I would be kind of interested to see if SNDL comes out and clarifies with maybe a shareholder letter in the coming sessions, just to clean things up, because there is going to be some confusion here among a lot of investors, traders, whatever you want to call it, right? That said, right, we're not going to hype this up, down, whatever. We're going to read what's in front of us and go off of what's going on. So understand that this is kind of, we saw something similar with DGLY, slightly different situation with DGLY, because they proposed an offering and then retracted the offering. They didn't retract a shelf. So that's a different situation with DGLY. And then DGLY, a couple of days later, ended up doing an offering. So just understand that, like, just because that maybe the headline reads that they retracted their shelf, I think there's a little bit more to that. So just understand that risk to the downside, although with how this was taken, you know, we got a little pop here. And so we're seeing how we're reacting. Let's take a look at the daily chart. We're kind of just in a range and we're consolidating, which is not bad. We have support down here in the lower mid to lower 60s. So 65, worst case scenario, 60 cents. We have a double top up around 79 or 80 cents. So we got to pop through 80 cents for a bigger move to the upside. But what we have is it potentially, you know, somewhat of a flag setting up, right? Kind of you have your support line right here, you have your top line resistance, and either a breakout to the downside below 60 cents or breakout to the upside above these two tops, above 79, 80 cents, you know, will signal the next move. And so obviously an offering, and we would probably send it to the downside depending upon the pricing, depending upon what happens with the offering, the size and whatnot, in the exact terms. But, you know, no offering now, and with what's going on, with the sector being, you know, still remaining pretty hot and the stock staying under a dollar, and it seems like it has a lot of bottled up energy, you know, that could send us to the upside. So if I was someone to trade this stock, currently not in this stock personally, I traded it from back here, swung it from back in here, the mid 40s up into the mid 70s, you know, as someone who may be looking to trade this stock, one thing to note too is that SNDL is not a great breakout trade. It's actually, in my experience in the past couple of weeks looking at it and watching it, it's a stock that you want to be paying attention when no one's paying attention, buying the dips, and that's paid off very, very well. It seems like once it gets news, once it gets kind of that breakout, like we thought once this registration or once this news broke, I thought that would send this stock, you know, in the after hours, and it got rejected at 75 and then fell back, and then the volume really just kind of faded off and it's just kind of hanging. So it's definitely a better dip buy, especially, you know, lately. If you are experienced, breakouts, you know, could be very, very profitable for you. But my experience that it just has not been doing very well with breakouts. Something's been holding it back and they're kind of playing games behind the scenes. So that's why personally, I would like to see some more clarification by the company here saying, hey, we got cash through X. We're not going to be doing a reverse stock split, this, that, and the other things. That's one of the other things to note here too, is that with the reverse stock split, right, that's how they're going to get their share price over $1, which they need to do so by June. That's their kind of, they got their extension until June to get their share price over $1. And so it seems like what's happening, what we talked about last video on SNDL, that, okay, it looks like what they're going to do is they're going to do an offering and then they're just going to do a reverse stock split. Now it seems like if they retract this offering, if they retract the shelf, or if they decide, hey, we're not going to actually, we don't have any reason to do an offering here. We don't have debt. We don't need the cash. Okay, cool. We can get our share price organically over $1 anyway, so we can avoid having to do a reverse stock split in the first place. So maybe that's the thought process here by the company, that they have enough reason to believe that they will be able to get their share price over $1 anyway before having to do a reverse stock split. So that's my thoughts currently. Hopefully you got something out of this video. Hopefully it cleared things up just a little bit. If you have any comments, thoughts, leave them in the comment section and down below. Like always, make sure to hit the thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel for more videos just like this. Also, don't forget to grab your 4-for-3 stocks with Webull when you sign up, deposit $100 to the platform. Also, you can get $30 in free M1 finance credit when you sign up to an account as well. Check those links out in the description box, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.